I know. I'm all right. I don't know even how to speak. I don't even speak English. Oh, hey there. I'm MC Haggis, the world's greatest Scottish rapper, and this here's my beatboxing partner, Seamus McFamous. Say hi to him, Seamus.
Hey.
Okay, this month we're learning about humility. It's ironic that we're studying that, because me and Seamus have humbly accepted an award, right, Seamus? Me and Seamus are the recipients of a very prestigious award in the Scottish music industry. You probably guessed it already. Yeah. Oh, hey. I know, Seamus, he'd be strong, okay. Me and Seamus are the humble winner... recipients... of the Susan Boyle Musical Excellence Award. Oh, thank you. Thank you. All right. Yeah, I see him too. So, we are waiting for this prestigious award to be delivered to us as we speak.
Oh! Hey! Oh! Hey!
Oh. Okay, hold on, I think it's here! Woo! Yes! I humbly accept this award with you.
Hey.
All right, oh, it's got a bow. Hey. I'm tired, and oh, here we go. Wow! Lucky, lucky! Huh?
Hey!
There appears to only be one award. This is awkward, right? One prestigious award to be shared by two humble recipients. I currently have possession of said award, so problem solved, right?
Aye.
Easy there, Seamus. I just think that I should be the one who wears it because it's my name that everybody knows, not yours.
Aye.
We're supposed to be showing humility, not putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve.
No!
All right. We're supposed to be putting others first, Seamus, so... Here you go.
Hey.
No.
Hey.
No, here you go.
Hey.
No, here you go. Hey. Here you go. No, here you go.
No, I don't want it anywhere near me.
Okay. Yeah. Let's just rap about humility. Kick it. There is a great ability for relational stability. Let's spread amongst you and me. It's putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve. And that's humility. Word.
Aye.
Word. You know what?
Hey.
I don't know what was getting on. You know what? Let's both wear it. Look.
Hey?
Yeah. Look. I'll see that works.
And you can see the award.
Yeah, look at that. That's great. All right, see ya.
Aye!
Okay.
Aye!
Aye! We gotta be in sync. Are you all right? Sorry. Okay. Let's take it off. You right?
Aye!
Oh, yeah, look at that razor burn.
Hey.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Okay, it looks like we're all set. Here is the water that you wanted. Uh-huh. Good job. Yeah. What's that? Want some music? Okay. Oh, you want a bedtime story too, huh? Okay, just one, all right? Okay. Once upon a time, there was a little seed that wanted to grow big and strong. That one day, a bird came along and...
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to... What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm gardening.
That's a flower in a bed.
It's a flower bed? Brandon doesn't know much about gardening, does he? What's that? Oh, you want a little more water? Okay. Uh-huh. Just drink that up. Good job. Good job. Uh-huh. Oh, we've got a leak.
Hello, all you crazy so-and-so-ians out there. I'm Brandon.
And I'm John.
And this is
the So-and-So Show,
which I'm sure you gathered already because I called you so-and-so-ians and there was an intro package and we had the title and now I'm rambling. John, why the computer?
I started a little project in the neighborhood.
Really? Do tell.
It's a community garden.
Oh, I've always wanted to do that! What's a community garden? Can you remind me?
It's a garden that everyone in the community can use to grow flowers and fruits and vegetables and stuff.
Ooh, stuff.
Yeah. So, you know, we can do that to share all that stuff with each other. And I'm about to find out what everyone's job assignment is.
Okay, very cool.
Yeah, but just because I'm in charge doesn't mean I get to choose the job I want. I made sure the assignments are totally random.
Oh, that's very big of you.
Well, thank you
very much. Okay, so when do we find out which job that we get?
You've got something in your digital inbox.
How about now?
Okay.
Oh, Brandon, you ready?
Oh, yeah. What job did I get?
Once a week, you will be a waterer.
Waterer?
Yeah.
I'm the waterer? Yes! Yes! I'm the waterer! What's a waterer?
You water plants.
Oh! That's still cool. How about you? What job did you get? John? John, are you okay?
No!
What happened?
You fainted and passed out.
I thought you were all wet.
That's how long you've been out.
What?
Yeah.
Oh. You know, all I can remember is opening up my computer and looking at my email.
Yeah?
No! What happened?
Same thing.
What?
Yeah.
You mean I opened my computer and I looked at my email and...
No, we're not doing this again.
Okay.
All right, what is going on? Okay, it says you got the job as fertilizer guy. What's so bad with that?
Read.
We will use all organic fertilizer.
Organic fertilizer?
Yeah.
Manure?
Oh.
Cow
cow patties?
Dodo. Yeah, okay, that's a little yucky, but it's what will help everyone else's plants grow.
Whoa, you can't seriously be telling me I have to do this.
Well, you said you wanted it to be random.
No, so. I started this thing. Why do I have to do this job? It's gross.
Okay, calm down. I'm sure we can get you some special gear and gloves and stuff to wear to do it.
Why couldn't I be the waterer? I would be a good waterer. I like water.
But I'm the
waterer. No way! As head of this project, I refuse.
You just refuse?
Yes!
Okay, listen. If you aren't willing to serve your community by spreading fertilizer...
Doo-doo.
Sure. Then I will swap jobs with you.
Wait, what? What? Really?
Yeah, I guess.
Wait, I'm the waterer?
Sure.
Yes! A job for a leader! I'm the waterer!
Happy?
Yes.
It's Bible story time with Kellen!
Hey, you two, what's up?
Oh, not much. How about you, Kellen?
Hey, why are you wet?
Oh, Brandon just did something nice for me.
Ah.
Hey, you got a story for us?
I do.
Then take it away.
Woo. Thank you. Well, today I have an amazing story about Jesus that I'd like to share. It gives us one of the most powerful examples of who Jesus is. But first, some backstory. For years, God's people had been waiting for a savior that God had promised, a Messiah, a king. When Jesus showed up performing miracles, the word got around that he was that promised king. So when Jesus came riding into Jerusalem on a day that we now call Palm Sunday, the people shouted out, "Hosanna!" and honored Jesus like he was king. But unlike most kings who want to come across all powerful and mighty, Jesus came to Jerusalem riding on the back of a donkey. A little clue to the kind of king Jesus intended to be. And that's where our story picks up today. And here to help tell it are the kids from...
Kidspective!
Jesus and his disciples had gathered together to take part in the Jewish tradition of Passover. It was a meal they would eat together to remember how God freed them from slavery hundreds of years earlier.
Peter, pass me some of those bitter herbs, please. Here you go. Thank you.
Can I have some too, Peter?
Of course.
Thank you, Peter.
Of course.
Now, when people would enter another person's house for a meal, a servant would often greet them.
Coming!
There were no doorbells back then, by the way.
Ah, so glad you can make it. Come in!
Thank you for having me.
Serve it!
Yes, sir.
Please prepare our guests for the feast.
One of the duties of the house servant was to do something we're not familiar with. Clean the guests' feet.
Oh my. Here goes.
Gross. I mean, back then, people's feet would get dirty from sweat, dirt, and well, sometimes organic fertilizer. Needless to say, cleaning someone's feet was not something anyone rich or powerful would do. But when Jesus and his disciples had gathered together for the Passover feast, Jesus did something shocking.
Peter, what's Jesus doing?
I don't know.
Looks like he's about to start cleaning.
That's weird.
Yeah, Peter, say something.
Lord, are you going to wash my feet?
Jesus replied, "You don't realize now what I am doing, but later on you will understand."
"But Lord, you'll never wash my feet."
And Jesus responded, "Unless I wash you, you can't share life with me."
"Then Lord, wash all of me."
Jesus told Peter that he was going to wash his feet. And then Jesus washed every disciple's feet in the room. A king got on the ground and washed their dirty, stinky feet. Afterwards, Jesus said, "Do you understand what I have done for you? You call me Lord, and you're right. That is what I am. I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet. So you also should wash one another's feet. I have given you an example. You should do as I have done for you." Now, we don't know for sure how the disciples reacted when Jesus did this, but I bet it was something like,
"Whoa!"
The end. Give it up for our kidspective performers. Every time I hear this story, it blows my mind. Jesus, the Son of God, the Messiah, washed his disciples' feet. He had all the rights and all the power in heaven to demand that his disciples wash his feet, but he didn't. Instead, he showed his disciples that true leadership is humbly serving those around you, no matter who you are.
That is an amazing story.
Yeah, really gets me thinking.
Hey, glad I could help.
Thanks.
See ya.
So I got you thinking, huh?
Yeah, I mean, Kellen's right. That story is mind-blowing. Jesus chose to serve his own followers and then told them to do the same? That is so upside down.
I know what you mean. Nowadays, it seems like people in charge want to be served rather than serve.
Yeah, well, you know what? Maybe I can do something about that. I'm gonna let you be the waterer, and I'll take the fertilizing job.
You don't have to do that.
No. I want to lead by example, and it's the job I was given, so. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go ahead and get prepared while you ask the question.
Right. Oh, you want me to do the thing by myself? Okay. Reveal the question! When has someone put you first?
Well, once when I was sick, my next door neighbor came over and mowed my lawn for me before he mowed his.
Huh. I mean, that's a great example. Yeah. One time in school when I was younger, somebody let me cut ahead of them in the lunch line so I could get the last piece of pizza.
Oh, that's very cool. Mm-hmm. I'm not very humble when it comes to pizza.
Yeah, but you are when it comes to gardening.
Well, I'm trying to be. You like my gardening outfit?
Hazmat suit.
Yeah. Oh, and a clothespin.
Okay.
Throw the fertilizer.
All right, well, that's one way to do it.
Oh, thank you.
Do it.
Thank you.
I did. Okay, that's all the time we have today. Until next time, I'm Brandon.
And I'm John.
And this was
the So-and-So Show.
You sound way different.
That's the price of power.
All right, one more little song to go to sleep. Simple, simple little flower. You'll grow as tall as a tower with your roots that run so deep. Birds will fly and shout a peep. Simple, simple little flower. One day you'll grow as tall as a we'll be right back.
I'm chosen by you. Forever, I'm your friend. You'll always be right here with me. I'm so thankful for your love. No matter what I do, I know this is true. You're by my side, you'll never leave. I wanna thank you, God, for showing me who I am. You're so good, you help me to understand. Chosen by you, forever I'm your friend. You'll always be right here with me. I'm so thankful for your love. No matter what I do, I know this is true. You're by my side, you'll never leave. I wanna thank you, God, for showing me who I am. You're so good, you help me. Love and kindness, I will see.